morning, everybody, and welcome. Thank you all very much for coming from as far afield as Canada, United States, Germany, Spain, Italy, Canada, and Scandinavia, etc. And obviously, my viewers from the UK. We got off to a very good start last night, which had Bridgeman very kindly giving a reception to the speakers and the main team. And now we're moving on to the main thrust of today's session, which, as you know, is author works. And we are lucky to have some very good speakers here. It's interesting that author works have been a subject of much interest in the last, well, quite some time, at least 10 years, and things now seem to be coming to a head. And by some strange coincidence, the day of the 4th of June is the day the Memorandum of Understanding will be signed by the 2010 Digital Libraries Group. So it'll be very interesting to get news back from Brussels. From Luxembourg, exactly. Thank you very much, Mark. What situation that is. I'm obviously not half as well qualified as anybody else to talk about the subject of our speakers, but just from my personal experience, having been trying to clear copyright for artists for the last 35 years through the Bridgeman Art Library, we're very aware of the tremendous problems. I remember some 20 years ago, a rather fashionable artist called Beatrice Parsons, who painted cottage gardens. She had 8 legatees who were her nephews and nieces, and they all lived in different nursing homes on the south coast of England. Intermittently they died and passed on their copyright to somebody else. But it was a tremendous problem tracking this, and we, in fact, were like who the people were. Very often the Tate and the Arts Council used to refer people to us, and much as we wanted help and on occasion could help, we certainly haven't got a totally adequate database, as indeed nobody had or has. So the more we can go to providing a slightly more satisfactory solution than we have at the moment, or hopefully a satisfactory solution, the happier I think we will all be.
Unfortunately, I'm not a expert either. I just kind of pull the strings together. I'm lucky enough to have experts, vastly experienced people here to tell you lots more. But really, I just wanted to kind of bring everyone's focus to the purpose of this project and the purpose of today, which is really to kind of discuss a lot of the problems that we've all become very aware of to do with orphan works. And to try and look at the different aspects of people from different industries. We've got people, as Harriet has already mentioned, people from the publishing industry, people from museums, people from the educational sector, and people from the kind of press stock heritage as well. So it's really valuable to be able to kind of bring everyone together so that we can look at the complications of finding any solution that has to kind of work for such a very kind of broad sector. And that's really the purpose of MILE. Much of this afternoon's discussion is going to be based around the concept of this orphan works database, which is one of the deliverables of the project. We're not really here to debate whether it's possible to have an orphan works database. This is something that we are kind of doing as part of the project. But it's more really to kind of use it as a test case to see how useful it can be for the stakeholders involved in establishing kind of practical solution of due diligence, whether an orphan works database can actually be part of the due diligence process. And I think there will be hopefully a lot of controversy and a lot of different opinions about how this might work.